It's Universal Pictures' highest grossing franchise and the seventh largest film series ever, grossing over $5.8 billion. Start your engines, because today we're looking at the Fast and Furious series. Which films were able to dominate at the box office? Which stalled out at the starting line? Today, it's all about the highest grossing Fast and Furious films. So be sure to stick around and see where your favorite film lands on our list. And remember, it's all about family.
Family.
This franchise has it all, folks. Fast cars, action, movies, video games, a theme park attraction, and yes, even a Lego set. There is simply no denying the popularity of this series. What began as a simple movie about illegal street racing way back in 2001 has grown and evolved into the blockbuster series today. Before we take a look at the billion-dollar movies, let's start with the less successful films. Fast and Furious Tokyo Drift is the lowest grossing film of the series. It actually only brought in a pitiful $158 million. Now, while this sounds like a lot of money, because, you know, it is, it did have a production cost of $85 million, so the profits weren't crazy high on this movie. This was the third film of the franchise, though, and they did not bring back any of the stars from the first two films because someone had a good idea, apparently. This film was directed by Justin Lin, who has actually gone on to direct 5 Fast and Furious films to date. The critics were surprisingly not the biggest fans of the film, but no matter the reason, Tokyo Drift finds itself as the lowest grossing film of the franchise. Drifting back on course, we have the film that started it all, The Fast and the Furious, released back in the ancient days of 2001. This movie set the stage for the entire franchise. Fan favorite characters went on to make their grand appearance, like Paul Walker, Vin Diesel, and Michelle Rodriguez. This is the cheapest film of the franchise with a production cost of only $38 million. Worldwide, this one actually went on to gross over $207 million. But even more than that, it helped to set the stage for the global juggernaut that we have today. Following the success of this film, Too Fast, Too Furious raced into theaters 2 years later. Vin Diesel actually did not return for this film, electing to star in The Chronicles of Riddick. Riddick ended up doing quite poorly at the box office, costing $120 million to make and only bringing in $115 million. Too Fast, Too Furious, on the other hand, only cost $76 million and brought in $236 million. And with the success of the second film, the studio knew that they had a gem on their hands. Following Tokyo Drift, which we already talked about, Fast and Furious was the next film to hit theaters. Real creative with these names here. This 2009 film once again brings back the main cast of characters as they drive really, really fast. One might say they drive fast and furious. The budget went up to $85 million this time, which they used a magic trick to turn into $360 million. This is over $100 million more than Too Fast, Too Furious, and marks the turn of these movies making money to making some serious bank. The fifth film in the series once again has an oh-so-creative title. This time, it's Fast 5. Dwayne Johnson makes his appearance into the franchise with this film, along with the returning cast of characters. Now, this film makes a change from the street race aspect of the previous entries to a more heist action flick movie. The movie's plot revolves around stealing $100 million, but here's the trick. They had to spend $125 million to make it. This film was able to make an astounding $626 million in the worldwide box office, which is $266 million more than the previous film. Now, before we go on to the next main series film, we have a little bit of a side story that fits perfectly here. Fast and Furious presents Hobbs and Shaw, featuring The Rock and Jason Statham fighting the genetically advanced super soldier that is Idris Elba. While this didn't feature the main cast, this 2019 film did feature a $200 million budget. And worldwide, it went on to bring in $759 million. Now that's quite a lot, but the numbers just get bigger from here. You know what else gets bigger? Our subscriber count. So if you like content like this, be sure to press that red subscribe button. Fast and Furious 6 was the next film in the franchise. And like Fast 5, this one had a more spy and adventure theme compared to the street racing that was the older titles. Each and every film so far has had a bigger and bigger budget, and this one is no exception. Estimated to cost $160 to make, this one would go on to gross over $788 million worldwide, which is roughly $160 million more than the previous film, Fast Five. Only two films left, and have you guessed the highest grossing film yet? Be sure to comment down below which you think is gonna top our list. Now, have you got your guess in? Because the second highest grossing film of the franchise is The Fate of the Furious. This film has a massive budget in excess of $250 million. They spent more on this movie than they grossed on Too Fast, Too Furious. And if you were asking if it was worth it, well, they went on to gross $1.2 billion. That's right, billion with a capital B. This was the third highest grossing film of 2017, losing out to Beauty and the Beast and Star Wars The Last Jedi. Currently, this movie sits at the 19th highest grossing film of all time, so it was definitely a big moneymaker. So which movie managed to turn $190 million into $1.5 billion? Well, if we want to work together and make a big brain move with a complex mathematical formula, we can figure this out. Or just look at whichever one's left over. And it turns out that is Fast 7. The group had strayed quite a bit from their roots from stealing VCRs in the first film and has upgraded capturing God's Eye, which was a program used to track people all over the world with simple electronic devices. This was the last film featuring Paul Walker before the accident, and thusly, the film was dedicated to him. Fast 7 sits at the top as the highest grossing Fast and Furious movie so far. The simply titled F9 is the next film set for release. This movie definitely seems like a good one, so we're gonna have to wait and see how it does at the box office and if it can race past Fast 7. These films have definitely evolved from simple street races in the first film. Overall, these movies combined to gross over $5.8 billion. But we need to know here, what is your favorite film? Be sure to let us know with a comment down below. For the Financial Fixation, I'm your host Dominic. Sorry if you thought I was Vin Diesel, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.